Netcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel VBA Chapter 13, Group by Week. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell. We're working through the VBA book. Chapter 13 is all about pivot tables, which are my favorite feature in Excel. Love to do pivot tables in VBA. The example that I chose for the podcast is when we need to take daily dates and roll them up. Okay, now, this is strange because this is the one example where we have to let the pivot table draw before we can go on. So normally we make all the changes to the pivot table and then at the end refresh the pivot table. But when you're grouping daily dates, you need to let the pivot table draw so we can select either the heading or the first date field, either one. And then in essence, what the macro is going to do is it's going to go to this dialog box. And notice, seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, quarters, years. Helps if you can remember the sequence of that because you're going to have to be able to pass a series of falses and trues based on what you chose. And in the macro, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say only days, that'll be the only one chosen, and then use this spin button to roll things up to 7-day periods. Okay, so that's what we're trying to do in the macro. Let's go take a look at the code. All right, so here we are. We've run the macro down to this point. And this is where we check and see what the first date is, and then do a little dance here to figure out what the previous Monday is. But once we have that, then we're actually going to use this group method, the group method. The curious thing about the group method is the periods field, which is an array, and again, it goes seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, quarters, and years. So you have to pass a series of falses and trues in order, and so you can see here that I'm using only the trues. Now, only the days are true. Now, once you've done that, then the cool thing is this argument, the by argument, becomes enabled. So I can say, hey, roll this up to 7-day periods, and I pass a start date to make sure that that start date is always a Monday. So we'll run this little bit of code here. You'll see that the start date is now whatever 40546 is, and we'll run that code. Now let's go take a look and compare the pivot table to how it looked at the beginning. Initially we had daily dates going down here, and now we have weekly dates going down the left-hand side. So if you work in payroll or a manufacturing plant or anything where you need to roll things up to weekly dates, a great little trick there to choose only days, only days from the grouping button, grouping dialog, and then roll it up to 7 days. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.